Hello everyone, welcome back and welcome to viewers to some more Stormworks. Today we've got an update and it's the sticky rotation update. The name of this, I have no idea what this means, so let's go ahead and read into this and see what they changed here. Dear Stormworkers, this week we are releasing a new update. Along with many fixes and improvements, we have added a new vehicle editor change, sticky rotation. So this is the workbench, I'm guessing. A component's rotation no longer orients based on the direction of the surface you are hovering, but rather responds to the rotation keys. This change is intended to reduce the issue of being unclear which key produces which rotation, why it always is the last rotation key that you try. Oh, so is this, okay, so I guess when we just hover around on a vehicle with a block, it won't sit there and flip around. Instead, we have to actually change that. We'll jump in and test that out. I think that's what that actually means. This change obviously reworks a fundamental vehicle editor behavior that many players will be used to. While we expect most players will be relieved that this has finally been changed, we also are aware that some players may feel that they are used to the old behavior, however confusing it was. Let us know your thoughts and feedback. I feel like I'm the same way. I've got almost 5,000 hours in this game, and I am used to the way the build editor works, but it always drives me insane when it doesn't respond to the right one. So I feel like it will be a little bit of a difference here where we have to get used to. It's a little bit of a learning curve, but it will get back over it. I think it'll be something that'll be easy to kind of get over. As well as this change, there are many fixes and improvements in response to player feedback on the issue tracker. Please see the patch notes below. Oh, quite a bit here. So the orientation is now sticky when placing components in the editor. Leaks not using their bounding when resolving the ocean, so boats not sinking. Not sure what that is. Crash fix for occasional issue with character input resetting. Hand item not clearing when teleporting. Seats applying an offset to character position when testing for drowning. I wonder if that's also going to change how you pick them up, because that's also been a problem. You have to look at the seat now to pick them up instead of the actual character, which I don't know why they changed that. Advanced rotor counter torque forces applying in space. Waypoints are now grid based and distance restraint has been removed. Ah, good. So maybe our waypoints are now grid based. I'm not sure what the grid based thing is, but hopefully the distance restraints being removed means that we can see the waypoint in the Arctic. We'll have to give that a go. Removed inert electrical node on liquid fuel rockets. Add-on references to remove node location data. Fixed lights issues on the arid island. Update classic mode description. Reworked raycast interactions to fix several issues with rays from recent character rework physics changes. Getting into some super technical stuff here. Reworked visual effects of fluid jets. Directional RX description error. Distance sensors high electric consumption. Resolve buoyancy mesh generation in an issue for gas tanks. Okay. Enable keypad waypoints to work on moon. Shows universal coordinates and not moon relative coordinates for Lua add-on compatibility. This is enabled keypad waypoints. This is cool because this might mean that we can actually get some GPS coordinates for the moon. Not actual GPS coordinates, but in-game coordinates. That might help with some navigation. I'll have to talk to some people about that, see what they think about that. Let's see, fishing rod inventory description, large solar cell priced. They changed that. I guess it's more expensive. Rebalance hoppers mass. Okay, so we'll have to see how heavy these are now. Lots of things to check out here. Let's see, let's go ahead and jump into the game. Let's see, we got the new sticky things here. I want to check that out. The waypoints I want to check out. Let's see, what else was there? I gotta ask about the keypads and then the solar cell price and rebalance hopper. So much to check out here. All right, we are in the world here. Before we go into the sticky block stuff, I want to check out the waypoints. I want to see how well that works, if that's actually been fixed. Let's go ahead and throw ourselves a waypoint up in the Arctic. Can we see it? Yes, we can. 103 kilometers away. This is an improvement. I'm glad they brought this back because this was a pain in the butt, not knowing which direction to go. I don't know why it changed. Maybe it was just a bug that got, you know, was a problem, and it's glad to see that that's been fixed and that is back. Very cool. I don't know what to do about the grid thing. I don't know what they mean by that. Maybe that's just something in the coding that we have, but we can see waypoints again, and that is awesome. What was the other things here? Rebalanced hopper mass. Well, I guess we're going into here. So I guess the thing they were talking about, let's say we've got a wall like this and a wall like so. I think the problem that they were talking about having is no matter what. Yeah. So if we were to kind of go from this wall to this wall, this block would flip. Now it stays in place. So now whichever position you have it in, It actually stays on. I dig that, because that's not going to be hard to get used to, because half the time it's like, oh, what is it? What is it? And you're changing it anyway. Now it will at least stay like that. Now when we have it like that, you can drag it. Perfect. If you wanted to flip it, you could do that. Flip it. It's not going to flip on you in the middle of actually building. And that's where I had the problems, is you'd be doing something and you come to try to, you know, hang something off the end here, and you had it just right and just perfect. And then you go to drag it and it's dragging a different direction. So that's an awesome improvement. I like that. I'll take that as an improvement. That is a good update. So let's see. We also had the solar cells. Solar cells. 48,400. Yes, no kidding. They changed the price of those. Holy crap. 400 each and 8,000 each. Yeah, those are pricey. I mean, solar panels have been pricey to begin with anyway. But yeah, now that it's... Now that they actually make sense on how much they cost, yeah. Are we going to ever use solar in game? Probably not. These need to generate a little bit more power for us, or give us some more electrical components to be able to make sort of, you know, more electrical systems. That'd be kind of cool. What was the other thing? Hopper. Reduce the hopper mass. Mass 60. 20. I don't remember how much these were before. These were a lot more before. This was like 200 and something, wasn't it? I'll have to go back and look at my old videos to see, but I'm pretty sure that these were double what they are. Maybe they did this because of fishing. Maybe that's what they want us to use them for, is actual nets now. I feel like that's a possibility with them being super, you know, reduced in weight here. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. Maybe it's just because of... Maybe it's just because mining is a pain in the butt and these things were overly too heavy. These things were too heavy and it was causing problems. Anything else here that we can kind of check out? The fishing rod. Let's see. It's inventory. Large containing spear gun. Press left mouse button to fire or to reload the spear gun. Where's the fishing rod? Large equipment release. Hold and release left button. Yeah, so I think they updated this here. So I think that's it. I don't think there's anything else. Yeah, that's about it. There's not much else to this update other than we got this new the new building mechanic here, which is kind of nice. I think that's a nice little update. I think that'll make things really easy to work with here. The waypoints are back. That's nice. The hoppers are lighter. Solar panels are more expensive. And there's been a bunch of other little updates here and there that have probably changed some of the small things in game, but nothing too big here. But yeah, guys, if you like these updates, make sure you throw a like on this video, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and we will see you guys in the next one.